We're heading to Komport, a remote village in the northeast, on the trail of one of Cambodia's strangest delicacies.
Another one, buffalo crossing the road. The size of it. Jesus.
When the Khmer Rouge ruled the country, food was scarce. During the famine, people were forced to eat wildlife from the countryside. Amazingly, over time, these necessities have evolved into Cambodian specialities. The most popular is tarantula.
The thought of catching tarantulas sounds a little bit eerie. Eating them, oh.
Well, everything's fresh, so when we do a fry, it's very tasty.
Very tasty. Have you ever been bitten by a tarantula?
Oh, never.
Never. You're crazy.
No, that's crazy.
The remote countryside around Komport is renowned for some of the biggest, best, and tastiest in Cambodia.
What a journey. This place is amazing.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Hello.
Yeah.
But before I can try them for myself, I've got to catch one.
Mr. Paul.
Mr. Paul, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Yeah, very indeed, thank you. Excited about these fresh tarantulas.
This good.
Boothe introduces me to Mr. Paul, king of the tarantula hunters. He's agreed to take me to his favourite spider spot, but worryingly, Boothe is leaving me to it.
Do they move very fast?
Because they have 8 legs, they move fast.
8 legs? You'd think they'd move bloody fast. Huh? And are they big?
Yes, big, about this big.
Bloody hell.
There's a real art to catching these hairy critters. They live in burrows deep in the jungle.
The size of that hole in there.
Yeah.
For the villagers, selling tarantulas is a welcome source of extra cash.
And there's only one tarantula in there. God, they go down deep, don't they? He's gone?
Yeah, he's gone. So when I was young, especially in the Khmer Rouge time, most people, they starve, so to fill the stomach, we had to eat all kinds of insects, even a snail or lizard.
Eating out of necessity, the Cambodians have developed an insatiable appetite for these eight-legged beasts.
God, that's a massive hole. Bloody hell. Got him? He's in there? Ah, there he is. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's a big one. If bitten now, it's painful, very painful.
Where are the fangs?
Yeah.
So he's not going to bite you now?
No, not
bite. No? Yeah, put him on me. Oh,
you pull him stronger.
That feels weird.
Furry here.
Jesus. You can hear how strong the head is. Huh?
Now it's my turn. Mr. Paul's discovered a really large burrow that promises a prize specimen.
So you can move the lid, you see the hole.
I face some really tough challenges on my travels.
Is it normally this deep down?
But there's something about these big hairy beasts that really gives me the willies.
Oh, here he is, here he is. He's not getting away.
Strong on him. You have to catch from the back, it's very strong. There? Don't let his head move, so he cannot turn the head to bias.
They're strong.
Very brave.
Jesus Christ.
Tiki Cameron.
I was amazed at how strong the head was. Really strong.
You're very strong.
Jesus Christ. Is that big enough to eat?
Yes, big enough to eat.
Yeah.
In some season.
Sorry. Okay. I mean, it feels really weird because they're furry and absolutely disgusting. And now you're going to tell me that is delicious.
Yeah, it's so full of the herb in the belly. So really delicious.
This is insane. Absolutely crazy. Okay, let's take him off. You little fucker.
Catching these hairy beasts is one thing. Now I've got to eat them.
Let's go.
We take our eight-legged haul back to the village, where Mr. Paul's cousin shows me her recipe for Cambodia's favourite snack.
Great stove.
After killing the tarantulas and boiling them in salted water for a couple of minutes, they're simply deep-fried in hot oil.
Jesus Christ, they're crispy, aren't they? Finger-licking tarantula.
After a few minutes, they're ready for eating.
Look at that. Oh, dear.
And the whole village has turned up to see how the Westerner likes their local speciality.
The moment we've all been waiting for. Okay.
How tastes?
It's good. I'm glad they're happy.
After the legs, Mr. Paul shows me the part of the tarantula that is most highly prized by the true connoisseur, the belly.
Yeah, the belly, yeah.
Full of something?
Yeah. Full of pus.
Yeah.
I've eaten some weird things in my time, but I'm really not sure about this.
It's bitter?
Yeah, it's very bitter. Can I just say, I prefer the legs. Weird texture when you're biting into it first off. It's like, crunchy chicken thigh, delicious. Bite through it and all of a sudden, burst of sweetness. Then it's the body and it's like a sort of bitter, bile, sour taste.
It's been a long day. After I said my goodbyes, I hit the road. As surprising as it was, I don't think I'll be putting tarantula on the menu for the royal dinner.